And Amanda, the story of the Matthew sisters just got more intriguing. Earlier this week, we broke the news of how their high-rolling Toronto women have been jailed in Lagos, Nigeria, accused of trying to blackmail wealthy Nigerian men. Tonight, a mysterious apology video has surfaced on YouTube.
We promise not to say anything of the contrary to what we are saying now. We freely volunteered to make this video and not under duress, because we are aware of the damages done to people.
Reading from a script off their cell phone against a nondescript background, a far different image of the Matharu sisters than what's on their social media accounts. Instagram pages filled with sexy poses, luxury brands, and flashy living. These are pictures of the sisters in court in Lagos on December 23rd, facing accusations of humiliating and cyberbullying some 274 people. The Toronto area women are accused of blackmailing the richest of Nigeria's rich, including this man.
We're doing a father-daughter Femi Kapi shoot.
Billionaire Nigerian oil tycoon Femi Otedola, who the sisters specifically named in today's video apology posted to YouTube.
We apologize to Femi Otedola and his family, especially his wife and children, and all the other petitioners.
The publisher of Politics Nigeria told me earlier this week that Otedola was the one who got the young women put behind bars.
There was a story they wrote, I read that story, against Femi. They said that he carried women and some of his politician friends to his yacht, that he cheated on his wife, that there are rooms in that yacht that he uses to sleep with women. He hired detectives who launched a full-scale investigation.
Today's apology denies they got any blackmail money, but that the website designer, who has also been charged, did.
The intention was not to hurt anyone or to be malicious. The intention was not to extort anyone. We haven't received any money from this website.
Court documents show Kieran's signature and Toronto phone number underneath a criminal undertaking that immediately upon my release for the hideous crimes perpetrated against various innocent individuals, I shall leave Nigeria and for the remainder of my natural life shall not re-enter Nigeria. It's unclear who shot this apology video, where it was shot, and where the sisters are now. Global Affairs has already told us that they are providing consular services to the sisters in Lagos, but did not respond to requests today about their apparent release on bail. I've spoken to Jyoti and Kieran's family in the GTA on the telephone. Their brother tells me they too have little information.
Well, to be honest, I don't really know what's going on. I don't really have any information. This isn't a country that, like Canada, it's in Africa, you know what I mean? So I really don't know what's going on, but it might not be what it seems. I don't know. Why don't you wait to speak with them directly? Because none of us really know any of the details.
Now, Jyoti and Kieran Matharu are believed to still be in Lagos. They have another court appearance on January 26th. If convicted of the crimes, they face a maximum 4 years in prison in Nigeria.